Hello students, a very warm welcome to my biology class. The topic for today's discussion is slide preparation for the study of mitotic index. In order to study mitotic index, you are required to prepare a slide which you will be viewing under the microscope to study the different phases of different stages of mitosis. So let's start. We are going to study mitotic index in Allium sepa or onion. Look at this. These are small sized onion. It is known as sambar iruli in common language, in local language here in Karnataka. These are used for cytology studies widely in the laboratories. All right. See, these onions are taken. And here you see, we'll do a little bit of processing before we move for the cytological procedure. We will be doing a little of processing here. Now let's see what type of processing am I talking about. Can you see this part here? When you take an onion, you can see a rough scaly part over here. You all have studied anatomy, morphology, all those things. So you know what is this. This is a condensed stem. This disc-like thing in an onion, this is how an onion looks, isn't it? This is how it looks. Here you have that condensed structure. From there, you see roots coming out. We scrape off this part gently. This part. While scraping it off, you will have to keep in mind that these parts, see this white parts projecting out, these parts should not be injured. Why? These are the root meristems. These are the points from where roots are going to come out. So these portions should not be scraped off. Okay? Now see, the procedure is pretty simple. The plant material used over here is Allium sepa or onion. What are we doing here? We are getting hold of onion. It is always suggested to get hold of, say, approximately 400 grams of onion so that you can observe, you can do a lot of studies from the same batch of onions. But well, that is not an important point. So you will first get hold of onion from the market. You will peel it gently. Okay, you will take out these dry scaly peels. You will peel it off and your onion is ready for planting. See, these parts are kept undisturbed. If you feel that you are not comfortable scraping this part, then don't scrape it. Not at all needed. If by chance you scrape this part off, then roots are not going to come out. So you can leave it as it is. Then you will plant it in soil or sand. It is good to plant in sand. Why? You know, when you are taking out these onions after 2 to 3 nights, what will happen? The sand is very loose. If you moisten the sand, it becomes very loose and it is easier for you to take out the onion without injuring the root tips. But soil, if you are planting it in soil, You'll have to be a little more cautious, a little more careful. Soil binds tightly in comparison to that of sand. But you can do both. Or else, a very easy procedure, you can simply dip it in water like this. The roots will grow. Can you see how luxuriantly it has grown? You can simply dip it in water. In that case, you'll have to make sure that these parts, this part is inside the level of water. Fine. This part should be inside the level of water. Then only the roots will come out. Okay. Now see, what are the materials required for this? You need glass vials. You need microscopic slides. New razor blades. Why new? The old ones, if you are using the old ones, you'll have to go on cutting like this, like this, like this, like this. It will not give a clear cut. The cut should be once like this. You should not rub your blade like this, like this, like this. It should not go on. It should be one cut like this. Scalpel, watch glass, drop bottles, measuring cylinders, Bunsen burner, sand. Sand for planting. This can be replaced with soil as well, soil or water, anything. Then blotting paper, microscope. It should be equipped with these lenses. Fine. Then you have, you need cedarwood oil for 100x. Chemicals. These are the chemicals you need. You need stain, you need fixative, all these stuff. All right. Next, let's start the procedure. This is the procedure. Fine. Onion bulbs are planted in sand, moistened and incubated in dark. Okay. So you will buy the onion, peel it, and you will gently plant it in the sand. Fine, you will keep it in dark. Why dark? Common sense, you know, roots grow better in darkness. After 2 to 3 nights of dark incubation, you should not take them out every day and see. You will keep it as it is. Make sure that the sand is not getting dried up. You will water the sand and you will keep it in dark for 2 to 3 nights. After 2 to 3 nights of dark incubation, the roots attain a length of 2 to 3 centimeters. That means approximately this much. 2 to 3 centimeters only. The root shouldn't go too big, too long. 5 millimeter from the tip of the roots are gently cut and dipped in 1:3 acetoethanol for over a night. So what is this first 5 millimeter? This is the tip region. See, this is the tip of the root. 5 millimeter means this much. It is cut and dipped in acetoethanol for over a night. That means you are keeping it in acetoethanol for one night. Correct? Now see, what is this acetoethanol? We will learn about this first. What is the purpose? Why are we just dipping it in acetoethanol? Why not in any other fluid, right? Okay, we'll come to this. Just note this first. The roots are then gently washed in distilled water and stored in 70% alcohol for future use. So the next day, what you will do, you will gently take those roots out from acetoethanol and you will wash it gently in distilled water. Okay, you will wash it gently in distilled water. You can do it with the help of a zero numbered paintbrush and then you will store it in 70% alcohol for future use. Okay, now see the process of dipping those roots in acetoethanol is known as fixation. The procedure is known as fixation. Now, what is fixation? Fixation is the selective preservation. It is the selective preservation of morphological organization. That is, you are preserving the morphology as it is. You are minimizing shrinkage and distortion. You are not allowing the cell to get distorted. You are preserving its morphology and chemical composition of tissues, rendering the cell contents insoluble with the coagulation or precipitation of protein matters. So this is the purpose, the sole purpose of fixation. Okay, proteins are getting precipitated, all right, and chemical composition of tissues and morphology of the cell is getting preserved. Okay, this renders the cell content insoluble. The cell content is also getting beautifully preserved. They're not getting dissolved or they're not getting distorted. They are not shrinking. So they are getting beautifully preserved. And why are you preserving it? It is for the purpose of study. Correct? Yes. The next purpose is it prevents bacterial decomposition. And the last and not the least, staining becomes easier. You know, why do we stain? Biological components are often colorless. And so to render them visible under microscope, we need a stain. Right. So the staining procedure becomes easier if those root tips are exposed to fixative. Fine, these are various examples of fixatives. See, can you see? Acetic, ethanol, various grades are there. 1:1 is there, 1:2, 1:3, 1:4. Okay. Acetic ethanol contains glacial acetic acid, and that is one part, glacial acetic acid one part, and absolute ethanol one part. In 1:1, it is two parts. In 1:2, three parts. In 1:3, four parts. In 1:4. All right, all these are fixatives. Other than this acetoethanol solution, you have 70% absolute ethyl alcohol, 45% acetic acid, Carnoy's fixative. All these are also widely used in laboratories as fixatives. Okay, here what did we use? Here we have used acetic ethanol 1:3 solution. Okay, it contains glacial acetic acid one part and absolute ethyl alcohol or ethanol three parts. All right? Yes. Next, see. Next, we'll come to the staining part of the root tips. Staining of root tips and slight preparation. The root tips, till now, what have you done? You have planted the onion, you have waited for 2 to 3 nights, and then you have taken them out from the sand, you have washed them, you have cut the first 5 millimeter of the root, that is the tip region. Why did you take the tip region? Because you will find actively dividing cells over there. All right. Then what have you done with them? You have dipped them in acetoethanol for one night, and then you have washed it with distilled water and preserved it in 70% ethanol for future use. Till here, it is clear. So what is the next step? Next step is the roots are then gently washed in distilled water. So you will take it out from 70% alcohol. Suppose this is your container. You have alcohol like this here, and your roots are all here. In alcohol, you have your roots. This is your 70% bottle. You will take out the root from here. You have your watch glass or petri dish. You will wash it in water. Now you will put this in 45% of acetic acids. You will take glass vials like this and you will put in 45% acetic acid. Okay, initially the root will float. It will then sink. Once it sinks, you will know that hydrolysis is complete. Once hydrolysis is complete, you will take the hydrolyzed root tips. Okay, the hydrolyzed root tips are then immersed in acetoorsin stain and warmed gently in glass vials. Why is this hydrolysis done? See, every step in cytology has got a purpose. This hydrolysis is done to make the cell walls little dilute. Fine? It becomes easier for you to squash the material for slide preparation. Okay? So, you are dipping it in 45% acetic acid. Initially, the root will float and then it will sink at the bottom of the vial like this. Once it is at the bottom, you know hydrolysis is over. Then you will immerse the hydrolyzed root tips. You will take it out from here. No need of washing anything. You will straight away put it in acetoorsin stain and warm it in the glass vial for a minute. Just a minute. See, it is 1 minute is not a protocol. You will have to boil it for 1 minute. Nothing like that. It shouldn't boil. It should not boil or it should not get charred. Okay, you will see, you will just heat it like, suppose this is the vial, you are heating it and you will touch it like this on your hand and see whether you are being able to feel the heat or not, like that. Okay, so after, see, this is the measurement of the root that you're supposed to cut and then you will put it in stain. Then you will warm it gently in a glass vial. After that, you will keep the vial undisturbed for 30 to 40 minutes. Now, in this 40 minutes resting time, we can learn a little about staining. See. Active stains have got active chemical groups present. So now let's learn a little about staining. The dyes with which you are staining, let's learn a little about those. See, active groups are present in the dyes. One is chromophoric group and the other is oxochromic group. The chromophoric groups impart color to the dye. Very important. The chromophoric groups impart color to the dye, while the oxochromic groups give the dye its ability to attach to the cellular component and to dissolve and dissociate in water. Very important. So you know what is a chromophoric group and what is an oxochromic group? This is clear to you? Fine. See, a dye again, let me tell you, a dye can also be acidic or basic. See, a dye can either be acidic or basic. Fine. An acidic dye combines at low pH. Remember, it combines at low pH. Okay. It is commonly used for staining proteins and cytoplasm. Correct. A basic dye has got a net positive charge and it is used for staining nucleic acid. Okay, this is, you can say, used for staining cytoplasm, protein. All right, but this basic dye has got a net positive charge. Remember, the basic dye has got a net positive charge and is used for staining nucleic acids. It stains nucleic acids. All right. Basic pushin, then methyl green, then crystal violet, all these. Fine. Let's give some example of acidic dye and basic dye. Acidic dye and basic dye. In acidic dye, you can add acid fuchsin, acid fuchsin. FUCHSIN, acid fuchsin, then you have Congo red, then you have methyl blue. Okay, now let's name some of the commonly used basic dyes. Basic dyes, basic dyes like methyl green, you have methyl green, then crystal violet. Okay, all these are basic dyes. All right. Now see, the chemical basis for staining is provided by the acidic or basic nature of dye. This is the chemical basis, right? It is provided by this acidic and basic nature. That is all right. There is also a physical basis for staining, and this is absorption of the dye. How much of dye is getting absorbed? This is absorption of the dye on the surface of the cellular structure. How much of the dye is getting absorbed on the surface? That is important, isn't it? The use of modants, it's a new word for you, right? The use of modants are very important. What do? They influence the absorption of stain. Helps in better stain absorption. It helps in better stain absorption. Okay. Modants such as iron alum may be used for staining. Okay, this is called pre-modanting along with stain, or after staining, that is called post-modanting. Fine, you just know these words. It's very important for you to know it. The stain that we are going to use over here is 2% acetic or sin, or 2% aceto or sin, not acetic, aceto or sin. We are using 2% aceto or sin stain over here. Now, how is it getting prepared? Remember, orsin is a basic dye which is obtained from a lichen. Very important. Orsin is a basic dye obtained from a lichen. Its name is Rosella tinctoria. The name is Rosella tinctoria. Rosella. What is it? Tinctoria. Okay, the name of the lichen is Rosella tinctoria. And Lecanora. L-E-C-A-N-O-R-A. Rosella tinctoria and Lecanora. This is an important point to be remembered. It is often asked in many competitive exams. All right. So you must know from where are you getting this basic dye. Okay. It is deep, very dark purple in color. Obtained from colorless parent compound or orsinol. All right. Orsinol 3,5 dihydroxytoluene. Now, how is it prepared? Let's see. How is it getting prepared? 1 gram. See carefully. 1 gram. Of orsin, 1 gram of orsin is dissolved in 100 ml of boiling. Let me write, is dissolved in 100 ml of boiling acetic acid. This is 45% acetic acid. That means you are dissolving 1 gram of orsin in 100 ml of boiling acetic acid. You are dissolving it in 1 gram. You are dissolving 1 gram of orsin in 100 ml of boiling 45% acetic acid. Okay, the solution is heated gently for about, say, approximately 10 minutes. Okay, heating for 10 minutes. All right, you should keep it at the simmering point. It should not be boiling vigorously and then overflow and all those stuff. You will cause accident. Now you will allow it to cool at room temperature. Cool at room temperature. All right. After that, you will filter. So after cooling, you will not filter it immediately. The boiling thing, this is not your boiling tea that you will filter it immediately and have it. You will allow it to cool at room temperature, then you will filter that. All right. Or else, this is one procedure. If you are doing it in a water bath, let me tell you the alternative path also. If you are doing it in a water bath, it should be heated for 3 to 5 hours. Okay. So in that case, you'll have to have condenser fixed with a conical flask. All right, you'll have to fix it with a conical flask in which the solution is prepared. Fine. So this is how you are preparing the stain. All right, now see, staining is done. The vials are then kept undisturbed for 30 to 40 minutes. After that, what are you doing? The stained root tips are dipped in 45% acetic acid to wash off the excess stain. See, once you take out the root tips, it is heavily stained. If you are working with that, you will stain your fingers, you will soil the working area. So it's always good to wash it. To wash off the excess stain, you again use 45% acetic acid. Now 2 millimeter from the tip of the stained root tip. Can you see this darkened part over here? This is cut. This portion only. Look at the picture, what I am coloring. This part is cut. Okay. See, I'm again doing it so that you understand. I'm again doing it. See, this part is cut. Did you see? This is 2 millimeter from the tip of the stained root, which you are cutting. 2 millimeter. It is mounted on a slide with 45% acetic acid and squashed. All right. These we have discussed. Now we will study. Now see. You will use this type of clean, grease-free slides and good quality cover glasses. Good quality cover glass, mind it, if they are not a good one, if they are not very fine and thin, you will have a lot of problem while viewing it under the microscope. And how to make these slides grease-free? You will have to wash it in detergent and don't use any cloth to wipe it. You will simply keep it under the fan. It will get dried up. You put it in your slide box. You will use slides and cover glasses of this type. You will put that 2 millimeter cut tip on the slide like this with 2 drops. 1 minute. See, you have your root tip like this. This is the structure of your root tip, right? The stained root tip looks like this. You will put a drop of acetic acid and you will put it on it. Then you will mount this onto this and you will gently squash it very gently with the tip of your thumb. Look, this is the tip of your thumb. You will squash it. Suppose this is your slide. All right. You will squash it like this. Like, not like this. It should not be like this. Okay. It should be like this with the edge. Like this. All right. You will squash it gently. And then what you will see is something like this. This is your microscopic field. You will see so many stages for the purpose of study. What stages can you see from here? Can you identify anything? Any stages? See, I can identify metaphase from here. I can identify metaphase, then I can identify prophase. Then I can identify here, you have another metaphase. Here also you have another metaphase. Here you have another prophase. So you can identify all possible stages. Interphase, prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase, everything you can identify. All right. So this is all about slide preparation. I have another video lecture for you, which has got the various stages of mitosis. Please go through that. I hope this video has helped you learn about the various stages of preparing slide for mitotic analysis. All right. Thank you so much for your kind attention. If you have liked the video or if you have felt that it is of use to you, then do share it with all your friends who are in need of it. Thank you so much for your kind attention. If you have any doubts, any confusion anywhere, please feel free to get back to me and I'll try my level best to clear your confusions. Okay, till then, bye-bye. Have a nice time. Take good care of yourself. Thank you so much.